Dear students of academics and competitive exams of English, in this lecture too, English medium lecture, today our topic is how to translate the sentences which are based on adverb 2. Students, first we will understand what is adverb 2. Students, we use TOO2 as an adverb when we exceed the limit of something. Especially when we say something about verb, adjective or adverb, then this TOO2 act as an adverb. Generally, you have come to know, if somebody is tired, normally tired, you say he is very tired. It means something positive can be expected from him. But if somebody is too tired, it means nothing can be expected from that person. वह कुछ ज्यादा ही सुस्त है means he is not able to do anything more or any longer. That's why when he is not able to do anything, there is a negative expectation from him. We use TOO2. He is too tired. वह इतना कमजोर है कि चल नहीं सकता. The same is here. He is too weak. But in this sentence, we add some extra portion in this sentence. He is too weak to walk. It means we clarify in what field he is weak. He is too weak means he is extremely weak to walk. Now we see when we translate this sentence, the English of the literal translation ki nahi sakta hai, we don't use. All these four words are used only in form of two. This single word too will act as the Hindi of ki nahi sakta hai. He is too weak to walk. Literally, students try to grasp the meaning from an English sentence according to the word meaning. In each sentence, it's not possible. You will go through the syntax. So, you should know the proper syntax of each type of sentence. Usne kare itna murkhtapurn kiya ki kisi ko bhi pasand nahi aaya ya nahi aayega. Both are the same things because these two actions are to denote future. And whenever we use TOO2, we denote future action. Now let's see. Usne itna murkhtapurn karya kiya. Usne itna murkhtapurn karya kiya means he performed his work too foolishly. Too adverb. Foolishly is also an adverb. For everyone. किसी को भी पसंद नहीं आएगा. Now you can see the subject of the first part and the subject of the second part are different. So we will have to write the second subject after four. And when we use four, we use them as an object. Suppose if there is I, मुझे पसंद नहीं आएगा, then I will have to write me because for preposition is given here and after preposition we use only objective form. For everyone to like. That's why I wrote this. Let's begin with sentence number 4. Aap to bahut deri se aaye hain. Sometimes in a story we speak half sentence and rest of the meaning is generally hidden in the sentence. Then the meaning, actual meaning is, means there is something missing. You are going to suffer something. You are too late means you have missed something. A negative result is expected. Actually, this sentence is similar to the sentence number 1. But I just wrote this sentence again in the number of 4 because I just wanted to make you see the difference of the words. Wah itna kamzor hai. And in sentence number 1, wah kuch zyada hi sust hai. But in sentence number 4, you see, aap to bahut hi deri se aaye hain. There are more words, but the translation is the same. In this way, one more thing we came to know is that we should not run after the word meanings. You should go according to the syntax, means structure of the sentence particularly. You are too late. The translation will be you are too late because something negative is going to happen. Yeh dabba itna bhari hai ki ise koi nahi utha sakta hai ya utha payega, whatever. The translation will remain the same. This box is too heavy. Now you see two different subjects are here, the box and the person who will lift, the lifter. Then I will write the box is too heavy for one. When the second object or subject is related to somebody, anybody, generally in negative sentence we use anybody, then we write the box is too heavy for one. We use the word one, one as a pronoun to lift. This sentence can be written, this box is too heavy to be lifted by anybody. It will be in passive voice. Now let's begin sentence number 6. वह इतना शक्तिशाली है कि उसे कुछ नहीं कहा जा सकता. द अंडरलाइन पोर्शन कैन बी रिटन इन अदर वर्ड्स कि उसे कोई कुछ नहीं कह सकता है या कहेगा. बोथ आर द सेम थिंग्स एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू. यू डोंट गो आफ्टर द सेंस यू डोंट गो आफ्टर द रिटन वर्ड्स. यू जस्ट गो आफ्टर द सेंस ऑफ द अंडरलाइन पोर्शन एंड द पोर्शन दैट इज रिटन आफ्टर इक्वल टू आर द सेम. सो आर ट्रांसलेशन विल बी ही इज टू पावरफुल टू बी सैड. He is too powerful to be said anything to him. And or you can also write the next part of the sentence. He is too powerful for one to say anything to him. Thanks.